Hi, everybody. This is Congressman Sarbanes. I just wanted to take a few minutes of your time to share some really, really good information coming out of the American Rescue Plan, which President Biden and Congress were able to get over the finish line earlier this year to help families across the country, including families in Maryland. We're going to talk today with some assistance about the child tax credit, the 2021 child tax credit, which is going to benefit most Maryland families with children across the state. They will be eligible beginning next month, so beginning in July, will be eligible to receive these monthly child care tax credits. Families will receive $300 per month for each child under age six and $250 per month for each child age 6 to 17, and that will be available through advance payments over the next 6 months, and then with benefits at the end of the year in the form of a tax credit. As I indicated, this comes out of the American Rescue Plan. We were very gratified to get that done to help people in many, many ways, but the child tax credit is certainly a significant boost for Maryland families, and we're looking forward to people taking full advantage of this over the next 6 months. I have enlisted an expert in this area, Rob Bader, who is the Director of Tax Operations with the CASH campaign. Many of you are familiar with the CASH campaign. That stands for Creating Assets, Savings, and Hope. They do terrific free tax preparation and assist families with the earned income tax credit, and now with the child tax credit, to make sure that people are taking full advantage of what's coming to them. So I've asked Rob to take a few minutes just to share with you briefly what the 2021 child tax credit is and how it can provide some real economic assistance to you in this difficult year. And then we'll have a few questions afterwards. Rob, I'm going to send it over to you now.
Great. Thank you. So thank you, Congressman. You've been very helpful to us in many ways by coming out to many of our events and getting the word out about some of the work we do, but also, and more importantly, like a lot of the legislation you've helped with, especially like the American Rescue Plan. So next slide, I guess. You can go then. So we're going to talk here about the Advanced Child Tax Credit and something that happened with the Advanced Child Tax Credit this year with the American Rescue Plan, is it expanded the child tax credit. But first, let me talk about what is the child tax credit. So if you're not familiar with it, it's a credit you receive when you file your tax return. So it's something you receive on your 1040, and it's for people who have child dependents. It's that simple. So it's something for years. People have been filing their tax returns. If they have a child, an eligible child, they would receive the credit. Next slide. And then usually it appears on the return as you file it. There's some differences that will happen this year. So the old credit, just to give you, it's really been expanded greatly this year and it has some changes. So the old credit, it was very powerful, very helpful for a lot of taxpayers, was $2,000 per child. Up to $1,400 of that was refundable. And give you an idea what that is. Refundable credits are very helpful. The earned income tax credits, one, American Opportunity Credit, that's a college credit, or education credit. It's basically money the government gives you. So it's not just a credit that just helps pay off some of your taxes that you owe. It's actually money that the government can put in your hand. So if you have no tax liability, it's actually money the government gives you. So it's very helpful. So and the old credit was great. We've loved the child tax credit. It was $2,000 per child, up to $1,400 of it was refundable. And it's for dependents under age 17. Just be careful when we say under age 17, that means 16 and under. The new credit for 2021 only, it's only for this year, but I know there's some discussion or some hope that that may be extended, but the new credit has been really expanded. You can see the amount has gone up drastically, $3,600 for age 5 and under, and $3,000 per child age 6 to 17. So we've actually added one more year onto the eligibility for the child. All of it is refundable. That's also amazing. So that just be aware that all of this is money that if you have no tax liability, it was just money the government will just give you. You will get this no matter what, whether you have a tax liability or not. And half, this is very interesting. This happens on occasion, very rare though with the IRS or with your taxes. Half is being paid ahead. Congressman Sarbanes just mentioned that. Half will be paid in advance payments, like monthly payments from July to December. They'll be paid generally on the 15th of the month, although August, I think, is going to be on the 13th. But generally, it's going to be the 15th of each month from July through December. Next slide. So who is eligible? What children make you eligible for the child tax credit? So first of all, you need to be related. The relationship test can be kind of complicated. I'm not going to get into the details of that, but basically you need to have a blood relation with the child. It does not have to be your actual child. It could be like a niece or a nephew or a foster child. So those children count. It can't be like a friend's child is living in the house, but it has to be some blood relation. But the definition of relationship is pretty broad. So if you have questions about that, you should talk to your tax practitioner. The child cannot pay more than half of their own support. The child has to live with the taxpayer more than half of the year. The child has to be the taxpayer's dependent. And basically, for the most part, if the child meets all the tests here, they're going to meet the dependency tests as well. The child, this is kind of a strange thing, but the child cannot be filing joint. On occasion they can, but for the most part, it's a rare thing. So don't worry about that too much unless you happen to have a child filing as married. The child has to be a U.S. citizen, U.S. national, or resident alien. And the child has to be under age 18. We discussed that as well. A lot of people will be asking a bit about Social Security numbers. That's SSN here, and ITINs, Individual Taxpayer Identification Number. So Social Security number, we all know what that is. ITIN, Individual Taxpayer Identification Number, is for people who cannot get a Social Security number and need a number, though, to file their tax return. As you know, we all put our Social Security numbers on the return. So some people need an ITIN. And that's given by the IRS. So the taxpayer must have either a Social Security number or an ITIN. And generally, people who get ITINs are people who are not eligible because of immigration, not eligible for a Social Security number because of their immigration status. So the taxpayer must have a Social Security number or ITIN. And this is going to cause some confusion because the child must have a Social Security number. They cannot have an ITIN. So just pay attention to that. And also the Social Security number is very specific. It has to be valid for employment as well. So doesn't mean the two-year-old child who cannot work is not eligible. It just means they have to have the number that does make them eligible. Next slide. So the advance payments. So a lot of people are asking about this because it's coming up in a couple of weeks or a few weeks here. Again, half of the child tax credits available for 2021 will be paid early between July 2021 and December 2021. They're paid automatically, right? Automatically, if the taxpayer is eligible on their 2020 return or 2019 return. So obviously we haven't filed our 2021 returns yet because 2021 is not over. We'll file them next tax season. So the IRS needs something to look at to determine if you might be eligible for the child tax credit. And so they're going to look at your 2020 return. Next slide. So they'll look at your 2020 return to determine that. And I'll talk with you a little bit about like, what if you're not eligible for, you know, if you're not think you're going to be eligible for 2021, or if you think you might be eligible, but you weren't on 2020. We'll talk about that in a minute. What is the monthly amount of the advance payments? So it depends on the age of the child, right? So it's going to be per child. And if the child's under five, it'll be up to $300 per month. Most people, I think, will actually receive $300 per month unless they're a higher income. And that's based on a $3,600 credit. So $3,600, I'll talk about the math in a second. If a child's under 18, but older than five, I should have said between six and 18, excuse me here. Between six and 17, it's up to $250 per month. And that's based on a total $3,000 credit. So the math, if you like math, it's over here. So if you have a child under five, that child would give the taxpayer a $3,600 credit. You only get advance payments on half of that credit. So that is then cut in half, $3,600 cut in half. That leaves you $1,800. $1,800 divided by the 6 months. So July, August, September, October, November, December, that's six if I count properly with my fingers here. That leaves you with $300 per month per child. Next slide. So there's a lot here. So some things to be aware of. If you do not file a tax return, you generally would not get the advanced payments because they need to look at your 2019 or 2020 return. But there's an option here. You can use what's called the IRS non-filer tool. To do that, you need to go to the IRS website and file. It's not a full tax return, but file some information with the IRS. So I'm going to put that here in the chat. And so that's the non-filer tool. So you'll have to put information about yourself and your income and some other things that identify you in there. If you are not required to file, generally it's because of your income level. If you are not required to file, I would encourage you to look at filing. Even though you may not be required to file, you may still get a tax refund. You could get an earned income tax credit, like a refundable credit where the government pays you. If you may get some withholding back, like if you've been paying withholding through your job, you may get that money back. So I'd encourage you to look at filing. But if you don't want to do so, you can use the non-filer tool. The IRS, I also put this in here as well, is the IRS tax credit update portal. So that's a new thing. They're just putting it together now. You can do a couple things with it. First, you can unenroll. What if you don't want your payments paid in advance? You can unenroll from that. And if you're married and that there's a portal in there, you have to put a lot of information in. You have to use this program called ID Me, and they identify you. I did it just to test it out with my family and my return. And I had to put my license in. They took a picture of the license, scanned a picture of me and everything else with my phone. So it's a little bit, there's some technology involved. Just be aware of that. But you can unenroll if you want your full payments when you file your tax return later, or if you don't think you're going to be eligible. The other thing that is not available yet, but this portal should be available soon, is an update portal where you really update your information, such as your direct deposit information. So your advanced child tax credit will go to the bank account that you used on your 2020 tax return. So if you had direct deposit on your 2020 return, it'll go into that same account. If you changed accounts, you should update it. If you did not ask for direct deposit on your 2020 return, you could actually input the direct deposit information in this portal and it'll come to you automatically from July through December this year. Other things to be aware of, sometimes people's marital status may change. There may be if there's a big change in income, and I'll talk more about income in a minute, you may want to update that. Or if you have the number of qualifying children, like if a new baby is born, you may want to include that. Or if a child moves out of the house, you may want to include that as well. Also, so just be aware. So those are probably the two most important things to be aware of, links to be aware of. Other things to know, if you want more information, IRS has a lot of information resources. They have a toolkit and they have FAQs. The toolkit is nice for yourself, or maybe if you're working with people who may be eligible. So it has a lot of information it also shows you how to use the non-filer tool as well. So it kind of gives you some screenshots, which are helpful to kind of understand how to do that. There's also a lot of FAQs, very detailed FAQs. It's probably more than most people would want to read, but they're very helpful. So if you have like detailed questions, I'd encourage you to go to the FAQs. Next slide. Okay. And so if you haven't filed your tax return yet, I would encourage you to look at free tax resources. So free tax preparation resources. So the IRS has, and I put a few of them in here, the IRS free file. So it's a lot of different tax preparation software companies provide free software. So it's all in the IRS free file. Be aware, I think all of them are free for the federal return. Some of them do charge you for the state, and also some of them will charge you if your income is above a certain level or if you're not eligible for the free program. Just be careful of that. But that is available. Our website has some programs as well. So I work with the Cash Campaign. So if you go to the Cash Campaign website, you can look there, and we do have some links to like TurboTax Freedom Edition and my free taxes and online taxes. So there's a few different free programs as well there. If you don't feel comfortable doing your own return, which I understand that, there are other tax preparation resources. So, I didn't put those in. So the cash campaign. So you can go look at the cash campaign website. We are preparing some free returns this summer. So there's some dates in there. If you want to make an appointment, we actually have a date tomorrow and Saturday. I would encourage you to go right after this presentation and sign up if you wanted to get your returns done in the next couple of days. But your income has to be under $57,000. We only do returns for income if your income's under $57,000. Also, the IRS is hosting advanced child tax credit free tax prep days around the country. Most of the dates on their program there are in the more of the DC, Rockville, that area. So just be aware that that's there. Next slide. Okay, so phase outs, just be aware of income phase outs. So the income thresholds are fairly high, but if your income, they will reduce the amount of child tax credit to $2,000 if your AGI is above $150,000 if you're married or widower, $112,500 if you're head of household, or $75,000 if you're single or married, filing separate. And there's also further reductions as well. They'll even reduce it further if your income's above $400,000 if you're married, filing joint, or $200,000 for all of my other married other filing statuses. Next slide. So what happens if the IRS pays me too much advanced child tax credit? I think we talked about this a little bit, but basically it'll be reconciled on the 2021 tax return. So if they pay too much, you may have to pay it back in 2021. If they didn't pay enough, you'll get more of it when you file your 2021 tax returns. Just be aware as well, though, there is a payment protection program that may limit the amount you have to pay up to $2,000, but it would be a limit of $2,000, but you would talk to your tax practitioner about that. There's some income limits and some people are eligible and some are not. So just be aware that there may be some limits. So it may be worth talking to your tax practitioner if you're trying to determine if you're going to be liable for any extra advance payments you may receive this year. And next slide. And this is my information here if you need to contact me. So I'm Rob Bader, I'm Director of Tax Operations of the Cash Campaign. My email is there. You can also find me if you look on our website. There's a lot of staff are listed there. So cashmd.org. Thank you. I think we have questions.
Thank you very much. Thanks very much, Rob. That was terrific. That noise you can't hear is people applauding because that was a very helpful presentation. So I want to thank you for that. And we do have time for maybe just a couple of quick questions to clarify things. What if somebody isn't employed right now, so they don't have income to show? Is that going to affect in any way their ability to access this tax credit? Can you just clarify that, please?
No, it doesn't affect it. It does affect some things like earned income tax credit, what have you. You do have to have income, but the child tax credit is not required.
Got it. That makes sense. Yeah. And then what about eligibility for other programs that somebody may be trying to access? Does the availability of this particular 2021 child tax credit, does it impact or affect that at all?
No, it doesn't affect it for at least 12 months, as far as I know, and maybe even longer, depending on your program. So if you're receiving Social Security, for example, or what have you, I think there's at least a 12-month window you could for any federal benefits. But you could always check with benefit provider and what have you, and more details, but it should not affect those at all.
Got it. And then I think you said this, and I may have said it on the front end, but this tax credit for now is available through the end of this tax year, 2021, not beyond. Is that correct?
That's correct. That's correct. Although I've heard some people want to extend that.
Well, I mean, we're certainly working extremely hard in Congress right now. President Biden has put forward the American Families Plan, which would actually extend this further. But the fact of the matter is that boosting it up, making it 100% refundable, as you indicated, is really a tremendous benefit in this year. And people are going to be able to access that, as you said, beginning in July and each month into December. They'll have availability for children under five of $300 a month, or children 6 to 17, $250 per month. And then the balance of the credit will be available to them at the end of the year. So this is really good for Maryland families. I think there's like 124,000 children, I think I said on the front end, in Maryland that will benefit from this child tax credit, which is tremendous. So we're very pleased to get that done for families in Maryland and across the country. Thank you, Rob, for lending us your expertise today. And I want to thank everybody who's going to take just a few minutes to benefit from this presentation. We're going to keep trying to bring you the good news about what was in the American Rescue Plan and what it's doing to lift up families in Maryland and across the country. Have a great day.
Yeah, thank you.